Good morning, everybody. I hope you all are fine. So let's continue our chapter number 5, that is cash flow statement, volume number 3, and let's discuss our activities. Activity number A, that is cash flows from operating, then activity number 2, that is cash flows from investing activities, then our activity number 3 is cash flows from financing activities. So the first activity is cash flows from operating, then investing, then financing. But I have already told you that we will start our question from the back. So firstly, I'll explain cash flows from financing activities. See students, you all know that in order to start any business, we need funds. Now the decision is from where to arrange or manage those funds. You all know that company can issue shares in order to arrange funds, right? Company can take loan from the bank or company can issue debentures. So these three major sources are there in order to arrange funds, right? It means what we have to do, now we have to see when we have issued our shares or debentures, when we have taken loan, whether there is inflows or outflows of cash. One more thing I want to tell you. See, the expenses which are related to these sources, we have to also write in under financing activities. For example, if I am issuing shares, it means I have to pay dividend to the debenture holder or share. I have to pay dividend to the shareholder. He has invested money in our business, who has purchased shares of our company, right? And if I have issued debentures, then I have to pay interest to the debenture holder. So these expenses, now if I'll take loan from the bank, of course repayment is also there. Moreover, I have to pay interest also on that particular loan amount. It means we have to write down the inflows and outflows as well as the direct expenses which are connected to that, right? That will also be shown here under financing activities. Now see, what are those sources which will affect inflows as well as outflows of cash? So the first is issue of shares. See, when we will issue shares, so we will receive money. So we will receive means there is inflows. Where there will be inflows, I'll put plus sign, and where there will be outflow, I'll put minus sign. Okay, so when I will issue shares, then money will be received. So inflows are, then I have written here plus. Then is loan taken. Of course, when you will take loan from the bank, to paisa aapke paas aayega, inflows. When redemption of preference, see students, generally shares, there is a case of buyback also in case of shares, but that is not in your syllabus. But in case of preference and debenture, the redemption is also there. Redemption means cancellation or repayment of preference or debentures. Then if we are making repayment, then there is outflows, we have to put minus here. Then of course, if I have taken loan from the bank, then it will be paid after a certain period of time. So when it will be paid, there will be outflows of cash. Then of course, to debentures, from whom we have taken loan, to whom interest will be paid. So when interest will be paid, we will put minus sign here. Then to shareholders, we have to pay dividend, so there will be outflows. So majorly three sources are there: issue of shares, debentures and loan. So all the expenses related to that, like payment of dividend, payment of interest, right, and redemption of preference and debentures, we have to write here under financing. After recording all the outflows as well as inflows, we have to make the total, and total will be shown here, right? We have to add all the plus transactions and deduct all the minus one. The balance will be transferred here. Right, now see, if we have arranged funds, now we have to invest those funds somewhere. So that is related to investing activities. Now the important decision is where to invest the surplus money, or where to invest money, whether in fixed assets. So there are two terms where we have to invest our money. First one is fixed assets. Either the company will invest in fixed assets or any investment. Means after investing the money, if any money is in surplus with the company, then the company would like to invest this money somewhere, right? Now if the company has invested the money in fixed asset, then now if we will purchase fixed asset, so there will be outflow of cash, so the amount will be deducted. Now of course, after some time, if we are feeling that our fixed asset is not up to date or we want to change it. So if there is sale of fixed asset, then we will receive money, then there is inflows. It will be added. Then see, now if I have invested money in shares, see, when we were issuing shares, we were receiving money from the shareholders, then we were paying dividend, right? But now we are investing money in someone else company's shares, we are investing. It means now we will receive dividend. So if any income is received due to that particular investment, so that we have to show under investing. See student, jahan pe paisa lagaya hai uske related agar income hai, so that will also be covered under investing activities. So there is inflows of cash, dividend received, so I have to put plus. Then is interest received. Of course, if the company has taken, not have taken, if the company has given loan to some another company, it means the interest will be received. So this is income, there is inflows. Now, if the company or if the firm has made any building and that building is given on rent, it means the income that is directly connected with that investment in building, so the income will also be added here. Right? So after this, after adding and deducting all, the final amount will be given here. Right? So these were two activities, cash flow from financing activities and cash flow from investing activities. In my next video, I'll discuss activity number A, that is cash flows from operating activities. Right? Please practice that. Thank you so much.